Microsoft Word was designed for all types of writing. Because of this, there's a lot of different settings that are useful and a lot that are not useful. Therefore, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you exactly what settings and things you should do so as to get the most out of using Word when writing your book. Plus, I'm going to show you a couple of tips and tricks in the industry. But before we begin, if you would like to learn more about book writing, publishing, and book marketing, be sure to hit that subscribe button as well as the little bell icon to the right so as to get notified when my next video comes out. And with that, let's begin. Okay, so when it comes to writing a book on Microsoft Word, there are really two phases: designing your manuscript and formatting that into a book. The process and settings you use between these two different phases is wildly different. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to best prepare your Word document for writing your book. And when you're done working with your editor and everyone else and you're ready to turn it into a book, be sure to check out my next video, which will show you all the settings and things you need to do to turn that Word document into a formatted book. All right, with that, let's go ahead and jump in to setting up your Word document for developing your manuscript. When you first open up Microsoft Word, you will want to make sure that all of your settings are set to the basic default settings for an optimal writing experience. Later on, we'll cover exactly what formatting will look like in order to make sure your book is ready for publishing. But for now, let's start with going through how to write the different sections of a book in Word. Now, if you notice that my Word looks a little different than yours, no worries. Depending on what version you have, you may find that the location of a few steps are not the same. However, to locate what version you have, just go to Word, About Word, and you can see your version number right here. You then may have to do a little Google search with your version to find the exact location of some things discussed. Under the Layout tab, we have our margin set to normal, orientation set to portrait, and size at a typical US letter page size. Next, let's go over character styles and set our font to one that is easy to read. The most common font for a manuscript is Times New Roman, and a font size of 12. After that, we're ready to start working on our book. Now, the first page is going to be the title page. Here, you will need to include your first and last name, making sure to use your actual name and not a pen name. If you are using a pen name, we will discuss where to include that later on. On the right side of your page, you will need to include your word count by going to Review and selecting Word Count. Once you are completely finished with your book, you can add the exact number here. Next lines are going to be your address, city, state, and zip code. Your email address is going to be the email you share with your editor or publishing company. Going to the middle of your page, you will need to center your text and in all capital letters, type out your manuscript's name. Two lines below that, type by your author name, and if you are writing under a pen name, you can add writing as and then the pen name. Ensuring that your cursor is located right after your name, go up to Insert and select Page Break. Selecting that adds another page and your title page is complete. Next, we're going to add headers and footers by going to your Insert tab and selecting either a header or footer. We will be creating a header with the left side including your last name and title of the manuscript, and on the right side, our page number. To add the page number, go to Page Number and select Right Alignment and choose whether you want to start page on the first page or after your title page. To change the format of page numbers, select Format and choose from more customizable options. Now, when it comes to a book, there are a lot of other pages that come after your title page, like the copyright page, the table of contents. However, we don't need to worry about this yet. That's something you do when you go to format it into a book, and that's something we'll cover later. For now, let's go ahead and move into styling our chapter headings. On a new page, about a third of the way down, we're going to write out chapter 1 and go to our Home tab to find our Styles pane. Yours may look a little different than mine, and that is okay because we'll mainly just be focusing on using heading 1, and sometimes you can also choose to use heading 2. Making sure we have our chapter 1 highlighted, we want to select heading 1 and then center align our text. Two lines below that, we can write out our chapter title if we so choose. After that, if you would like to change up the size or font, you can. Feel free to mess around with this to your liking and just make sure to keep the format to heading 1. You can also apply those new font settings to your heading 1 so as future chapters will look the same as well. Doing this and using header one is gonna make creating your table of content as well as your formatting that much easier down the road. That's why I suggest just go ahead and doing that extra step now. Another tip when writing is if you find that you want to include a seam break at any point, adding three stars and center aligning them is the most commonly understood way. This is called an ornamental break. Okay, so now that we have our book fully written out as well as broken into proper chapters like we just discussed, next I wanna look at some of the tools and things that authors should use inside of Microsoft Word so as to get a better experience with the process. First is the different writing views. The most common writing view is focus view. This is because it's the least distracting. You can toggle it in and out of this mode down in the lower right corner. As you can see, there are no more tools, bars, or pans all around, and you can easily focus on just your writing. You can also switch between seeing one page or two pages side by side when writing. I personally like to keep it on two-page view because I get a better feel on how it would be in a physical book setting. Another great feature Word has is the navigation pane. This can be located here under the View tab. As you can see, we can easily scroll through all of our pages and easily click on any of the pages to go directly to it. The next part of the pane does require that you have a little bit of formatting involved, but that is exactly why we already created our chapter headings the way we did, because Word sees this and automatically applies it in the navigation pane. This is going to show us all of our headings and subheadings, and we can quickly navigate through them just by clicking. The Review tab is awesome if you are writing by yourself, an editor, or a formatter. If you or someone else working on the manuscript makes any comments or changes, they will show up here as long as you have track changes on, which you can toggle on and off under the Review tab. This is great for protecting your work while also letting others make suggestions and changes that you can go through. One thing to keep in mind when sending your document over to different editors is you might want to set a password so that not just anyone can open and make changes. To do this, make sure you are in the Review tab and select Protect Document. Here, you can set passwords and have your document set to be comments only or read only. Although that step isn't exactly necessary, it is one of the things I like to use, especially when working with multiple people, so definitely keep that in mind. The next feature in the navigation pane is going to be your Find and Replace feature. This feature allows you to search for specific words or phrases and replace them in all in bulk if necessary. This can be very handy if you have character name change halfway through and need to replace it. And finally, there's the grammar and spelling editor, which you can access here. Okay, so there you have it. With this setup and layout that we just discussed, you should be able to get a lot more out of Word when writing your book. But like I said, Word wasn't designed for writing books. It was designed for all types of writing. And there's a lot of software out there like Atticus that was designed specially for writing long form things like novels and books. It includes things like proper front matter and back matter, as well as formatting rules, writing rules, goal trackers, habit trackers, and everything else that an author would want when trying to write a book. Also, Atticus allows you to write offline and online, which gives you the best of both worlds in protecting your work and allowing you to work from anywhere. All right, so there you have it, guys. We now have a better way of using Word to write our books. I hope you enjoy this video. And with that, I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur, signing off. Cheers.